Hi everyone, welcome back to Drupal Academy. If you are new here, make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of our Drupal tutorials. In this tutorial, we are going to walk you through the process of importing file content into a content type node in a Drupal 10 using the fields module. So let's get started. Before we dive into the actual import process, let's briefly talk about the fields module. The fields module allows you to import or aggregate content into your Drupal site from various sources such as CSV, JSON, XML, and RSS feeds. It is a powerful tool that makes data integration simple and efficient. First, we need to install the fields module. For that, you can go to the download section of this module, check the your Drupal version. So my Drupal version is 10. Click on this URL, open it in a new tab, download the zip file and place it in your contrib directory of your modules in your website and extract here. After that, go to your backend of your website, go to the extents. Search for the fields module, click on this checkbox. So for this demo purpose, I have already installed this module. After checking this checkbox, click on the install button to install the module. And another step is you can download this module using the composer. For that, just copy this command, composer require drupal/fields, and go to the git bash or in your terminal and paste it here and hit the enter button. It will download the fields module. After downloading this module, to enable this module, run this command /en fields. Now we have installed the fields module and it is now available in our Drupal website. Next step is we need to create the feed type. So before that, I will show you the content type in which I want to import the CSV data using the fields module. I have these content types and I want to import the CSV data into this my employee content type. This content type has these fields, email address, name and the salary. And now I want to import CSV data using the fields module into this content type and create the nodes of those contents. So for that, first we need to create the fields type. For that, go to structure, click on the fields types, click on add field types, give it a name as per your requirement. I want to import data into the employee content type, so I will give it name as employee data. In the description, I will add description as like employee import. Next, you can add some extra guidelines or explanation about this import, like the what columns names you need to set. Next, from the fetcher, select the option as upload file. In the parser, select the parser type as a CSV because we are going to import CSV file. In the pre-process, we are going to create the nodes, so we will set it as a node. Also, you can import the data into different entities like taxonomy terms, user form submissions, users, URLs. So we will set it as a node. And in which content type we want to import the data, so we will select it as a employee content type. Next is selecting the default delimiter. So our CSV file will be the comma separated. We will set it as a comma. And after that, click on save and add mapping button. On this page, we need to map our fields with the CSV file. I have this CSV file and I want to import this data into the employee content type using the fields. So first target is the name of your content type fields. So first we will select the title as a field, and in the source we need to set the which field we want to map with the title field. So from here select it as a new CSV column source and give it a name as a title. Make sure to enter the exact CSV column name. This is case sensitive. Suppose if you have right here like this title as a T as a capital, and in the CSV file you mention T as a small letter, first T as a small letter, then it will not import the data. So make sure to keep the name which are mentioned here in the source field as well. So we have mapped now title with the title field. Next field is the name. This is the employee name. Again select here as a new CSV column source and map it with the name field from the CSV file. Next field is the email address. This is from our content type, and map it with our email field in the CSV file. So select it as a new CSV column source and name it as email. The last column is the salary. So select the salary from content type. Map it with our salary column from the CSV file. There are some other attributes as well. If you want to make these fields unique, you can make unique by checking this checkbox so that it will not allow the duplicate data into the selected unique field. The next step is save this configuration. For that click on save button. The configurations are saved successfully. Now go to the content. So first I will show you there is no content in the employee content type. From this drop down select the content type as employee and click on filter. Here you can see right now there is no content for the no nodes available for the employee content type. Now we will import this CSV file data into employee content type, and it will create the nodes for each row. So for that in the content click on the fields. After that click on add fields. Give the title for your fields. So we will give it as a employee data. Choose the file. So we will choose this employee data CSV file. In the CSV file here you can see right now there are 10 records. We are going to import these 10 records. Next delimiter, select the delimiter. So we will set delimiter as a comma only. After that click on save and import to import the CSV file data into employee content type. Here you can see the 10 records are created for the employee. Again go to our content. In the filter select content type as employee and click on the filter to filter the employee nodes. So here you can see the 10 records of the employee imported into the nodes. So I will show you first record by editing it. So first record is the John Doe, its email address, salary, and in the CSV as well you can see in the title we have added the employee one, in the name name is John Doe, email and the salary. Sometimes we face issues while importing the data with the special characters. Suppose I have the some Spanish special characters in my CSV file, like in Spanish they use the A like this. So I will add A here. Instead of A, I will write this special character. I will delete the other records. Save this file and we will give it a title as 11 and the 12. And now I will try to import this file again. For that, go to content fields, click on add fields to import this data with the special characters. Give it name as a employee data 2. Select the CSV file and click on save and import to import the data. Here you can see employee data 2. It has imported the just one employee data, and here we are getting the error for the second record, like this value does not match the expected character set. Again, go to content and we will check if the employee 12 is imported or not. So here you can see only the employee 11 is imported. To fix this issue, we need to open this CSV file. First close it here and open this file into Notepad+. In the encoding, set the encoding type as a UTF-8 and correct the special characters. So after changing it to UTF-8, the special character is changed to this XE1. So correct those characters, add the actual character here, save this file. Now we will import just this record with the special character. Again, go to feeds, add feeds, give the title as employee data 3, choose the file. Click on save and import button to import the data. Here you can see now that employee with the special character is imported. Again, go to content. That employee 12 is imported successfully with the special character. I will show it by editing it. So here you can see the Jane Smith with the special character. So that's it from this tutorial on importing CSV file content into content type nodes in a Drupal 10 using the fields module. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any question, put them down in a comment box. Please don't forget to subscribe for more Drupal tips and tutorials. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next tutorial.